What's up, rockers? Welcome to E.
The breakdown.
10 of the breakdown, like she said.
Oh my gosh, it's the 10th episode.
10. It's like the anniversary of, you know, those couples that do like, it's our 10-week anniversary. Oh my God. What are we going to do? Oh my God. We've been seeing each other for 10 whole weeks. Oh my God.
We have all been hanging out for 10 weeks now. Crazy.
It's like official or something, you know.
It's like I don't official, know. Official.
It's like I don't want to put a label on it or anything. But thought this would be fun covers episode. We did throwback songs. Now we do our favorite covers because bands are doing a lot of covers, and they're pretty bitching. Some of them are fucking sick.
They are. People are really killing the cover game lately.
And not just like our favorites are not just like, you know, oh yeah, they did a cover song. Like they reimagined it and they changed the whole tone of the song with their cover. Because as soon as you change it, you change how it sounds, you change how you hear it, and it can affect you differently.
Mm-hmm. For sure. I have a feeling I know some of who you picked already.
I don't know. Maybe one. There's a
I think just one. maybe not like the exact cover, but
the person,
the band. Yeah.
Oh, I think I know who you're talking about. No, I didn't put them on here. I know who you're talking about.
Wow, nice.
We go. Your first favorite cover.
Okay. I don't know if these are like my favorites, but they're my favorites right now. They're newer. And this is like brand spanking new. This is was just released on Friday, and it's Lilith Czar covering Edge of 17.
From her new album.
Yes, and I didn't realize she was covering this. So when I was listening to the album, I was totally caught off guard, and I think her voice is perfect for it. So let's make sure I share the sound. And
her voice reminds me of what's that artist called, the Dancing on the Chandelier girl? Is it Sia?
Sia. Yeah.
She reminds me of her, but in rock format.
Interesting. Now I have to listen to her with that in mind.
Remember to keep the volume a little bit low for the damn copyright monetized bullcrap damn YouTube and your monetization. Right there. That is perfect.
Like, first of all, how can you just like not love this song? But her like raspy voice.
Exactly.
So good.
Yeah. I think this was such a out of like the left field album. People are just like, whoa, this is freaking bomb. I love the album artwork. I love the album name, Created from Filth and Dust. That's so sick.
Yeah, the intro leading into it, the whole like concept of it is really cool. But like this cover's in the middle of it, I think, and it totally took me by surprise, but it's so good.
It would be cool if she does a throwback like music video for it too. That would be really cool, but reimagined or something.
Yeah, her like visuals and everything are so cool, so if she did a video for this, it would be really cool, I think. Not everyone can do Stevie Nicks, but Lil Czar did it.
Nails it.
All right. We won't play too much so we don't get
monetized, monetization.
So we don't get in trouble.
Monetized. That's the word. Of the day, monetized.
Don't say it too much, they might
like, whoa, you said monetized way too many times. We're gonna monetize you for monetizing. Yeah.
Oh God.
Mine, I'm gonna do a lot of controversy with them, but I'm separating him from the music because this was a freaking still a bitchin' cover song and such a great soundtrack for Not Another Teen Movie. Marilyn Manson, Teen in Love. Such sick music video for it too. I remember when it came out with that for the movie, and they blurred it out for all the naked parts, but you know what? It's still fucking great.
It is a good cover.
And again, I'm separating the artist from stuff that's happening right now. So yeah. We're just doing music. Music, people. Music. If you can separate freaking Motley Crue from their music and their antics, you can separate this.
The most common question we get.
That was real. What is this? Is what's the difference between level 3A? Why am I getting body armor? I am body armor.
Yeah.
Oh, that intro, that reimagined intro of it was that like gangster is boom boom. This reimagined freaking new metal sound, so freaking dope. And I love that they got that all the actors from the movie in it too.
Yeah, that's cool.
Night. Such a great cover. I'm sure everyone knows it of it and all that, but I think this is a great reimagining of a classic. And they had Joey Jurgensen from Slipknot in there too, who's sitting on the couch.
Oh, cool.
When he was still in Slipknot. But I love when artists can do these reimaginings, like this, change the whole tone, add their extra stuff to it. And that's what makes like these covers, when they do their reimagined version of it, sick.
Oh my gosh, this actually reminds me of a cover I wasn't even thinking about, but now I feel like I have to do it. Okay. Yeah, we're gonna do this one. I love this artist. She's not even like rock, but she covered Rob Zombie's Dracula. I think for a movie. But it's so good.
I was almost gonna do. I'm glad you're doing. Oh, there's Motionless in White did a cover of Dracula for their like, I think their second debut album or their debut album. Yeah, their debut album. And it's such a sick cover.
Mm-hmm.
Right, now this is Danzig, not Rob Zombie. You horrible
person. Oh, wait, what is this?
Oh, there we go.
Here we go.
Whoa.
No, I don't know what that was. Sorry.
Wait, is this Lizzie Ward?
No. Here we go.
Whoa.
I love her voice.
Whoa. No fucking way.
Like, slow and like.
Sick.
Spooky.
Damn, I'm adding this to my music to listen to. That's so cool. Wow. I hope they have it on Spotify. They do. That is so cool. I love
this shit. I'm so glad I remembered this one.
I love this shit. This shit is dope. Dang.
Like, who doesn't love Dracula? And then I just love Lissie's voice. So when I, and it's just like a, not something you'd think she'd cover. So, but it's done so well.
That is so dope. Surprised Zombie didn't like put this on his Instagram. I'm like, dang, you guys, check out this cover. Like, he normally does that kind of stuff. Damn. That's so
fucking so good.
That's cool. I'm listening to that after this. That's like, that's good. That's good reading background music.
Yeah. For sure. Mm-hmm.
And that could be a good Halloween playlist. Add that one on top of the original one. That'd be sick. Like, I can see that like during some crazy kill scene in a horror movie or like some very depressing moment, and they have that music playing through it. That was a good choice. Mine is similar to yours in a stripped down version. He's my favorite songwriter to date. His name's Shawn James. Interviewed him at one of his shows. This dude is like, his voice is ridiculous. Like, I've never met an artist who sounds amazing on recording, but sounds better live.
Mm-hmm.
Even his live recordings, his live like stuff he releases digitally, sound better than the studio produced mix stuff. Like, this dude is just better live.
And yeah.
He did a stripped version of Iron Maiden's Number of the Beast. And oh my God.
I'm excited for this one.
This is just like the Rob Zombie. It's like totally changes the tone.
Oh yeah.
I'm about to drink some mud.
I don't want to drink your mud, dude. Bro, mud.
I did it
like they were, because and they had a violinist with them. Ugh.
This is gonna be good.
Hello. His voice is just like, he's very anti-religious, but like, he doesn't like kind of like churches, I guess, power control thing, but he used to be in choir, and that's how he learned how to sing. But when he goes into like the breakdown,
dang. It's crazy how you can, like, honestly hear a song and be like, wait, let me do it a completely different way.
Yeah. I'm always just amazed by this dude's voice. Ugh. I never get tired of this song.
This is so cool.
Sex. The dude is like unnatural. The singing voice is crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Most underrated.
His voice against the violin, really nice.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Mine is Crown Lands, who Kiki just interviewed for Banded, and they covered Feeling Good. So that's gonna be a little bit more of a beat. You deserve a car that thrills you. A car that goosebumps on your goosebumps. Yeah, originally Nina Simone. Dang ads.
Another slow strip. It takes so much creativity to be able to reimagine a classic song, because it's like when you listen to it, you have it stuck in that one way you're hearing it, how they made it. And then to break it down and try to slow it down and do a whole different version. Hard, really hard.
Yeah, for me, it would be really hard to get past just like hearing the original version in my head every time.
I like it. I dig it.
Got some like classic rock Zeppelin type vibes.
Yeah. Very nice. I agree with this. Now I'm feeling
good. I know, I was just jamming to this the other day. I'm like, damn, they did really well. Another example of, like, I would never expect them to cover this either.
Now that they asked, that question in an interview, like, yo, how did you guys come up with this cover?
Yeah. I don't think she did.
Uh-huh.
She could have. I know.
That would have been good.
Missed opportunity.
Yeah. So I'm gonna change the tempo up a bit. I'm throwing it back to like 10 years ago, back in the post-core emo core days of that sideway hair, you know, My Chemical Romance stuff. And when TikTok hit the scene with Kesha and this band, they're no longer around. There are a couple of the members formed different bands projects, but the band's called Woe Is Me. And back in the day, there used to be Punk Goes Pop albums, and they were just like, and it just became more metalcore bands just doing like crazy covers of pop songs and making them the most metalcore way. And they did a Kesha cover, and it's pretty freaking sick.
Oh my gosh, this reminds me. Oh my gosh,
like look at that hair. That's some 2000 shit right there.
Scene kids. A firm lets your customers pay over
time, which makes sense. You gotta hit the beginning. In the morning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
But it, where it's at. I think it's a, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Whoa, I wish they would bring this back, like this kind of stuff.
Oh my gosh, Sam. In high school, there was the big like hardcore band in our scene covered that song Laffy Taffy.
Oh yeah. So they did a few of because like it was always like the same rotations of bands on the Punk Goes Pop albums. And they did a few other covers that are pretty cool too.
Oh, I miss Pop Goes Punk, or Punk Goes Pop, whatever way it goes.
Pop Goes Punk, yeah. That'll be a funny album. Pop Goes Punk.
Yeah, actually, that would be pretty interesting. Okay, I'm like stuck on what I want to do for wine. I can either go new or I can go old. We're gonna go old because we are. I'm gonna do. So I was recently talking to someone about this Van Halen covered Dancing in the Street, and 5,000 other people have also covered it.
Yeah, but Van Halen is better.
Yes. But I was just surprised at how many other people have covered it. Like Mick Jagger and Bowie covered it.
Yeah.
Phil Collins covered it, which I had no idea.
Make sure the volume's a little bit low on this one just for the, you know, monetization. Because Van Halen.
I could do the live version. No, no. Okay.
You can.
We'll just do this one. It's not going to be as exciting. My gosh.
Right there.
Yeah, but out of all the covers of Dancing in the Street, I think they did the best job of taking it and making it their own.
Yeah, I agree.
Because it's not like dead on like they did their Van Halen thing.
Yeah.
It's a little fun.
Like when I think of this cover, when I think of Dancing in the Street, I think of Van Halen automatically. I don't think of any other version.
Yeah, same. Same. Like, I don't even think of the original. Like, I'm sure most people don't even know the original. I didn't even know that Jagger and Bowie covered it. Like, recently.
But they believe Roth's voice is just, like, it's perfect for it.
Mm-hmm. I think he was the one who wanted to do the cover for this, too. Like, he brought it up to the band.
Yeah.
Always the fun one.
Yeah.
I thought was there not a music video for this one?
I don't know.
So I thought there was, but maybe not.
I don't remember if there was.
Like there.
I'm really old, but I'm not that old.
Same.
I'm gonna go a little, stay on the hard track for my last one. I'm gonna do. Britney Spears, Oops, I Did It Again by Children of Bodom.
Oh my gosh, I'm
it's
pumped.
So great. they did a whole album dedicated to covers, and it's cool because it's just like, they go crazy thrash metal, Swedish thrash metal, and then just do pop covers. Mm-hmm. It's so great, and it just automatically changes the song.
It really, they, I,
what's that?
I just really like when heavier artists cover pop. It's the best.
Did they have a music video for this? No way. I've never felt so close to the possibility of disclosure. And then like they, it was great. They also did like, they covered everybody. Yeah, they did a music video for it. No way. That's great. Or is it? No, it's not. Someone just spliced it together. Lies. Liars, you,
oh yeah,
you dickheads. You didn't do music video for it, whatever. I'm gonna go see that. Liars, fakers. All right, here's the cover.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, yeah. I think I did it again. I made you believe we're more than just friends. Yeah, I'm serious. Yeah. It's so great. It's Swedish thrash metal meets pop.
Meets the pop princess. I wonder, like, what, like, why they did it. Like, why'd they choose this one? They're like, oh, I just feel like covering Britney Spears this week.
The question is, why wouldn't they? That's the better question.
True. True.
But that whole album is great. Like, their covers, they did Ramones. Someone put something in my drink. Who put something in my drink or something like that? They did all these great covers. It's so, and it's like all different still. And it's such a sick album. It's like 15 songs. It's long. Like, it's not like, you know, they do like 5 songs. Oh, we did a cool little cover EP. No, they did a whole album dedicated to covers.
Damn. That's impressive. And very unexpected. Well, the Britney Spears selection anyways. I like it.
All right. Show and tell music. Spear fingers. Metal hand spear fingers. These aren't spear fingers. These are spear fingers.
What are metal spear fingers?
Just when a metalhead does it. That's what it is. That's exactly what it is.
Fair.
All right, it's rock and roll. Let's do it. What's your choice? What's your new music for the release?
I have to like remind myself who I picked. Oh, here we go. So I actually think that I want to say that we found these guys in one of our previous videos. Oh, you know, it's not gonna pop up. Oh shoot. Okay, well, we're gonna have to do Spotify. Sorry. Dang, people want videos. So, anyways, this is gonna be Haunt. And
beautiful. Ooh, yeah, that's right. We put
imaginary borders.
We found these guys when we were doing. Whoa, it's loud. It's incredibly loud. Yes.
So sorry.
Whoa.
My bad. Yeah, I think we found them when we were doing our top rock.
Yeah, the streams, the verses, the two different playlists, and we saw these guns on the iMusic playlist for hard rock.
Mm-hmm.
I remember I was listening to the album right after. Their guitar player shreds.
Yeah, the whole album's really good. I was listening to the whole thing, and this one, Imaginary Borders, really stuck out to me.
I really want to get a shirt with that whole artwork on it. Yeah. That's so cool.
The artwork is super sick. I would wear that shirt, too. Let's see. Haunt about... traditional heavy metal from Fresno. Haunt is here to keep the spirit of underground metal alive. We love to see it. All right, we won't play too much so we don't get in trouble.
Mine is actually still on the by I unknowingly forgot it was a cover, but cover keeping it trend, but it's a new song by Lilith Czar, she's freaking bopping right now, and she did this song in Paradise City, that new TV show, and it's a cover of Queensryche and I Don't Believe in Love, and it's dope. I love her version of it. It's pretty freaking bitching. People were probably like, most people would be like, who the hell is Queensryche? Like, they're an old 80s band before your time. They had like a small moment in time when they were huge and then they kind of dropped off.
I love Queensryche. What's the, they have one song that I'm Upsells with.
Skip, I don't want to do that. Yeah. That's for, and they had this fake band called the Mavens in it.
I haven't gotten that far in the show yet.
Whoa.
Okay, yeah, okay.
Here we go. Here it is. Yeah, I like this cover. Yeah. And I like the bass sound of this. Mm-hmm. I like it. This song is dope. That would be another good thing we can do. We can do a covers list.
Yeah. Covers list. That's a good idea. Cover. That was a good one. That was a good one. All right. My last one is the band Thundermother.
Thundermother.
You can't handle me.
It's easy.
Shoot, I gotta make sure I don't blast the volume again.
Yeah, get that cowbell in there. Bring it down a little
cowbell,
bit.
Please.
Bring it down a little bit more. There we go. Yeah, that's perfect. Yeah, Thundermother. I vibe with it.
Oh yeah, their stuff is good. They've been coming out with new stuff recently, and I think their album came out not too long ago too. Maybe. Is there? They got some good stuff.
I vibe with it. I fuck with it. I like it.
All female band.
Mm-hmm. I dig it.
They.
I'm going to go with Escape the Fates. Their new album came out, and one of their songs, their big one that's getting talked about is Lightning Strike.
Ooh.
Lightning Strike.
I haven't listened to Escape the Fates in a hot minute.
They changed their sound up with this one. I see why they did. This is a stadium anthem right here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. I see this being a walkout song. A walkout song for a fighter, somebody. Mm-hmm. Damn it. Volume. There we go. No. They need to expand this thing to make it like bigger. But like the guitar player Thrasher, he's producing a lot of music with like MGK and everybody. And he's getting so much musical influences and you can hear it.
Oh yeah. I feel like I read about him working with people all the time.
So like you can hear all the influences that he's been working with has been creatively going with into his music, which is awesome.
I like it. I might have to go listen to the album.
Lightning Strike!
Very nice pick.
That is Show and Tell. Great covers. Great music releases. Good influx and wave. Different styles of covers. Slow and easy. Fun. Poppy. With a heavy metal twist.
Classics. Yeah. It was a good mix. Very good mix. Now I want to go listen to Punk Goes Pop All Night, though.
Yeah, I agree with that. Do it. thank you guys for watching another episode of Breakdown. Let's hope there's no issues when we edit all this stuff together. Horns up. Or like my buddies, when festivals are back, we do the ultimate horns where everyone does their fists together, and then the last two people have their pinkies out for the big horns.
Oh gosh, can't wait to do that one day.
Soon. The big horns. Thank you guys. We'll catch you again.
Thanks for watching.
11.